Welcome dear learners to my YouTube channel Learn with Shivi. I am Shivi Gupta and today we are going to understand the difference between transitive verbs and intransitive verbs. Now before we start understanding the concept, I would request you to please like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel Learn with Shivi. So now without further ado, let's get started. But before we go on to understand what are transitive and intransitive verbs, we need to first understand what is an object.
What is an object?
An object of a sentence is the person or thing that receives the action of the word. Say, in a sentence, if you are able to identify the subject and the verb of the sentence, then you can easily find out who is receiving the action. In other words, the object. Also, an object will always be a noun. It will be something that you can relate to.
Identifying an object in a sentence is very simple. But what you have to do first is identify the verb. After identifying the verb, you have to question it with a who or what. And whatever you get as an answer will be your object. For example, let's have a look at our first sentence. I know him. Now in this sentence, what is our verb? Know over here is our verb. And if we question it with I know who or you know who, then what you get as an answer is him. So him over here becomes our object. Similarly, in the second sentence, she ate an omelette. What is her verb? Verb is ate. And what did she eat? She ate an omelette. So what does an omelette become over here? It becomes our object. I hope you are easily able to identify objects now. So without further ado, let's move ahead and understand what are transitive verbs and intransitive verbs. Transitive verbs refers to those verbs which cannot complete the sentence on their own. They demand an object to create or make a meaningful sentence. Whereas the intransitive verbs refers to those verbs that do not require an object to act upon. They are self-sufficient. They can make meaningful sentences on their own. Now let's try and understand both transitive and intransitive verbs with the help of examples. Let's have a look at transitive verbs first.
As we already know, transitive verbs require an object to express a complete thought. For example, in the first sentence, please pass the bottle. What is our verb? Pass. Now, if I remove the rest of the sentence, which I know is the object, then what will be left with us? Please pass. Now, will it make any sense? Will it be a complete sentence? No. Hence, we know that this verb over here requires an object, which is the bottle. Thus, pass becomes our transitive verb. Now let's go and have a look at the other examples. The second sentence is, the students called their teacher. Now in this sentence, what is our verb? Called. And again, if I remove the object, will it be a meaningful sentence? No. Hence, called becomes our transitive verb. Similarly, in third sentence, Rohit loves dancing. Now, Rohit loves. Is it making any sense? Rohit loves what? Rohit loves dancing. Hence, loves over here becomes our transitive verb. I hope you've understood it well. Now, let's have a look at intransitive verbs. These are those verbs which do not require any object to construct a meaningful sentence. Intransitive verbs are meaningful in themselves. For example, the sun was shining. Now in this sentence, what is a verb? It is shining. Now, does it have any object? No. Is it a meaningful sentence? Yes. Hence, shining is an intransitive verb. Now, let's read the second sentence together. They danced. What is the verb here? Danced. Does it have an object? No. But is it a meaningful sentence? Yes. Hence, danced is an intransitive verb. Similarly, in the third sentence, only the verb is written. No other object or subject, nothing is written. But is it still making a meaningful sentence in itself? Yes. Hence, run becomes our intransitive verb. Now, let's check whether we've understood the concept well or not through a little exercise. In this exercise, you need to identify the verbs in the following sentences as intransitive or transitive verbs. First sentence, Sneha ran a publishing house. Now, what do you think, children? What sort of verb does it have? Very good. It's a transitive verb. And how did we recognize it? By recognizing whether the verb needs an object or not. And we come to the conclusion that it does need one object. So, we declare ran over here as a transitive verb. Now, let's look at the second sentence. Has he eaten his lunch? What do you think, children? Does it have a transitive verb or an intransitive verb? Very good. In this sentence, eaten is a transitive verb. And how did we recognize it? Because we identified the verb first, which was eaten. Then we identified whether has he eaten in itself is making a complete sense or not. Does it need any object or not? And we come to the conclusion that it does need an object, because if we question it, what did he eat? We get his lunch. So, eaten over here becomes a transitive verb. Now, let's look at a third sentence. She reads. Now, again, the verb over here, is it making a complete sense in itself? Yes, it is. Thus, this sentence contains an intransitive verb. Now, in the fourth sentence, you have to let me know in the comment section below whether the sentence contains an intransitive verb or a transitive verb.
I hope the topic was clear to you through my video. If you still have any doubts, please let me know in the comment section below. And we'll meet in the next class, in the next video. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Take care and like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Learn with Shivi.